Hello everyone, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So today we are going to discuss a lot of interesting facts and news which is relevant for your RBI, SEBI and ABAD examination. So let's begin today's video. But before that, if you haven't subscribed to our channel, then do subscribe and hit the bell notification. And also guys, you can join our Telegram channel as well, where you will get free quizzes as well as you will also get to know about the latest updates regarding examinations as well as regarding the new uploads on our channel. Now guys, before moving ahead, let me tell you that we are running a series of revision lectures for Spotlight magazine, which I take on every Monday, Wednesday, Friday at 10 a.m. in the morning. Okay, so if you are not aware about it, then I have told you this thing. So be there on Wednesday to cover the current affairs for the month of March, because for April, May, June, we have already covered the current affairs. You can watch the sessions on our YouTube channel. But if you have already seen that, then do not forget to watch the March session as well. Okay, so on that note, let's begin with the first question. Which has become India's only city to be selected for International Clean Air Catalyst Program? Delhi, Gurgaon, Ghaziabad, Indore and Noida are in the options, which, out of which Indore is the right answer. So first of all, this International Clean Air Catalyst Program has been launched by US Agency for International Development, which is also abbreviated as, this is international. Which is also abbreviated as USAID. So this organization has launched this challenge or launched this project basically. This is not a challenge, guys. So this is a project that has been launched by USAID in partnership with a consortium of global companies. So there are a lot of companies that are helping the USAID in this project, but the major nodal agency for launching this project is USAID. Now this project has been launched in order to catalyze. Catalyst is to fasten the process. So catalyze the process of cleaning the air in low and middle income countries. So this program will run for 5 years. Okay. And in the 5 years, the initiatives related to cleaning the air will take place in the city of Indore from India. And there is another city that has been selected for this program, which is Jakarta, the capital of Indonesia. Jakarta and Indore, these both cities have been selected on a pilot basis for this project. So do remember this thing, that there are two cities, Jakarta and Indore. And this project will run for 5 years. Apart from this, there is nothing from this news that you need to remember. My question from you is that, can you tell me which international organization has its headquarters in Jakarta, Indonesia? So this is your task that you have to mention in the comment section below. Moving on to the second question, which is a very important question. So what is the score of digital payments index in March 2021? First of all, this index is released by RBI in the month of January this year only. This index was launched. So what is the score in March 2021? The score is 270.59 is the score of digital payment index that is released by RBI. Now guys, this score is a very positive score, we would say, because this index has seen an improvement. Why am I saying this? You will get to know when you see this picture. So first of all, this has been taken from RBI's official website only. But before moving on to this table, let's first read what we have in this slide. Okay. So this RBI DPI, that is Digital Payment Index, has demonstrated significant growth in the index, representing the rapid adoption and deepening of digital payments across India. This is a very important point from your understanding point of view, that digital payment infrastructure is increasing. Digital payment adoption is increasing because of the widespread use as well as availability of data, internet inclusivity, as well as the digital payment infrastructure, which is also improving in our country. The index series, since its inception, is as under. So 2018 has been taken as the base year, therefore the score is 100. Okay, so 100 is capped as the score for 2018, because 2018 is the base year. Then in March 2019, when this was the score, then you can clearly see that the score is increasing. And remember that March and September are the 2 points of times when this index is released. Okay. Now let's look at this index a bit more deeply. So this index was launched in January 2021. 2018 is the base year, and therefore the score is 100 for 2018. Next is from March 2021, DPI will be published semi-annually, that is twice in a year. That we have already seen that RBI has released the index for 2019 and 2020 for 2 times, March as well as September. So that is already there. Parameters of DPI, these are very important. So 5 parameters are these: payment enablers, which hold 25% weightage; payment infrastructure; supply side factors, hold 15% weightage; payment infrastructure; demand side factors, hold 10% weightage; payment performance, 45% weightage; and consumer centricity, 5% weightage. So you have to memorize these factors along with their weightage. Okay. RBI has also announced, so this announcement was made back in January 2021 when this index was launched. So a new self-regulatory organization for the payment sector was announced by RBI, that it is going to set up this organization, but till now this kind of organization has not been set up by RBI. So that is the current update. But remember that since RBI has announced it, so sooner or later it will establish this kind of organization or provide guidelines regarding this. As and when the guidelines will be provided, I'm going to tell you in the morning mails itself, so you don't have to worry about it. Now, before leaving this question, I have a question for you. And that question is, you have to tell that which committee recommended RBI to launch this index. You have to name the committee that recommended this index to RBI, and remember the purpose of this index, that is to assess the digitization of payments in India. So it is the committee that was set up by RBI only for the purpose of digitizing the payment infrastructure in India. So if you remember, if you have done the committees thoroughly, then you would know the answer, and quickly give the answer in the comment section below. So I will be waiting for your answers, guys. Do mention it. Which committee was it? Moving on to the next question, who has been appointed as the CEO of Bharat Bill Pay? So this Bharat Bill Pay is basically the arm of NPCI, National Payment Corporation of India, and it basically handles the work of payment, bill payments, recurring nature of, recurring type of bill payments. So who has been appointed as the CEO of Bharat Bill Pay? It is Nupur Chaturvedi. Moving on to the next question, which city will have the lightest metro train running in India? So which city is going to have India's first and lightest train, metro train? Pune, Ahmedabad, Hyderabad, Kolkata, Delhi. The right answer is Pune. So here you need to know some important facts regarding this, India's first lightest metro train. First fact is that it is made of aluminium, which makes it lightweighted, as well as it is very efficient in carbon emissions. It emits carbon with less in comparison to other trains. It is very safe, okay, and also it is very light. So that is the feature itself, which is mentioned in the question only. Second feature is that it has been made by Titagarh Wagon. So this Titagarh is basically a place in West Bengal, and this company is based there. This company is located there. So its European arm, which is known as Titagarh Fire Arm, has got the contract from the Government of India to manufacture, design and develop 34 such lightweighted Italian style trains. And out of these 34, so first of all, this contract was given in 2019, and out of these 34 trains contract, this company Titagarh Firearms has developed the first train, and the manifestation or the demonstration of that train took place in Italy. So this first, India's first lightest train actually ran on the tracks of Italy recently. It was basically launched virtually from India. So that was something that is not important for us, but for understanding point of view or for knowledge point of view, we need to know this point as well. Okay, so that was all. Now this train is going to be delivered by December 2021. So by the end of this year, this train will come in India in Pune. The next point here is that all these 34 trains will be delivered by 2024. So that was the another fact related to these lightest metro trains. Okay, they are very carbon emission efficient, as well as they are very safe in comparison to the other trains that we have. So that was all about India's lightest metro train, and it is going to be Pune's first such train. Moving on to the next question, who has received the NetWest Group Earth Heroes Award 2021 in the Earth Guardian category for best management? So basically, which tiger reserve has got this award? So the award has been given to Satpura Tiger Reserve, which is in Madhya Pradesh. Now guys, this NetWest Group Earth Heroes Award. So basically, it is the Earth Heroes Award 2021, which is given by this NetWest Group, and this award is given in different categories. A total number of 5 categories are there in which this award is given. So what is important for us is right in front of you. Satpura Tiger Reserve has got this award in the category of Earth Guardian, or basically for best management. So that was all for this question. Nothing much and nothing more. But my question from you is, how many, or not how many, basically you need to name the tiger reserves that are present in Madhya Pradesh apart from the Satpura Tiger Reserve. Bahut hi simple question hai, right? So I know that you guys can answer the question, so do mention the answers. Okay, when is the Global Tiger Day observed? So the right answer here is July 29. And what is the theme? Their safety is in our hands. So that is the theme of Global Tiger Day 2021. So guys, that was all for today. I hope that you have learned something new in this video. And if you have, then first of all, do mention the answers in the comment section below. And secondly, you can share this video as much as you want. Thank you so much for watching the video.